There aren't many more things invigorating this time of year than a bike ride, but have you ever thought of taking your rides a step further?
Say, like leaving your car parked in the driveway and then riding your bike to work? Well, next week is National Bike to Work Week, and next Friday, May 18th, National Bike to Work Day. And if safety and a lack of bike lanes has you worried, tonight's newsmaker, here's your concerns. You see, it's Matthew Burczyk's full-time job to address them, and recently, I joined him in his office.
Yeah, I try to bike every day. I figure, you know, if I'm trying to get other people to try to ride and walk, I should be doing that myself. My bike to work is a little over 2 miles, so I live relatively closely, but you know, there are a lot of neighborhoods surrounding downtown that are within 2 or 3 miles, and that's sure. An easy bike ride. That's, you know, that's 10 minutes for me in the morning.
You could call him the city of Winston-Salem's biking and walking chief. The city pays Matthew Burczyk about $47,000 a year to be its top proponent of bike lanes and walking paths. It's his job to cut through and handle all the bureaucracy that goes into adding and building them.
You know, we have our long-term plans that we develop for, you know, where do we need greenways, where do we need bike lanes, where do we need sidewalks.
Burczyk considers this roundabout along Main Street just south of Old Salem to be the city's hub of non-motorized vehicle transportation. Not only is one of the city's longest walking and biking paths nearby, the Salem Creek Greenway, a lot of streets with bike lanes come together here. It's also close to two of Burczyk's biggest priorities, extending the Salem Creek Greenway south to Forsyth Tech and adding bike lanes on Main Street south to Clemensville Road.
You know, once we figure out where we need a bike lane, for instance, or a greenway, you know, the next steps are, where do we get the funding from?
Sure.
How are we paying for it? You know, what permits do we need? What, you know, who do we work with for construction?
Have most people been fairly receptive to the ideas that you put across? You know, because a lot of people, you know, for people who drive to work every day, I mean, it's kind of hard for them to relate to bikes or to walking.
There are always people who are going to be opposed to certain projects.
Yeah.
But what's really heartening for me is that there's been so much support lately.
Right now, Winston-Salem has about 23 miles of greenways, and while the goal isn't to build one greenway that circles downtown, the city does want to better connect the 9 or 10 separate greenways that exist on the west, east, and south sides. As for adding to the 8 miles of bike lanes the city has right now, well, that can be a little more tricky. Is there enough pavement already to just paint in some lanes, or will you have to buy property, widen the pavement, and then stripe the lanes?
You know, we get a resurfacing list, so we see what projects are going to be resurfaced for the year, and we try to piggyback on those projects.
Why is it so easy for you when the road is set for resurfacing?
Yeah, we have a blank slate to work with, so, you know, we have a blank canvas. We can restripe that however we want to.
Burczyk's also not trying to put a bike lane on every street or highway.
And what we're trying to do with the bike lanes is hit on streets that, you know, are a little busier, that, you know, people need to use.
The city's also started using a new tool on narrower streets. Markings like this are called shared lane markings, or sharrows. Not only do they help warn drivers bikers may be ahead, they help position the cyclist in a good spot away from the gutter pan where garbage collects. And that's not all.
It gets them away from the door zone. So if there's on-street parking, we don't want cyclists riding right next to the car, because if somebody opens their door,
exactly,
there's going to be a crash.
But no matter how many bike lanes or sharrows the city paints on pavement, Burczyk says the key when it comes to safety all goes back to drivers and cyclists sharing the road.
You know, we're trying to educate cyclists to behave responsibly, and we're asking them to do that.
Sure.
But you know, if you get behind cyclists, or you have to wait for pedestrians to cross the street, it might cost you 10, 15 seconds.
Sure.
But it's better to do that than to risk somebody's life.
Education's also a key part of what Matthew does. His office has produced a Winston-Salem bike map as well as safety brochures. All of this is available on the internet. Greensboro has a similar website, and we've put links to both on ours. Just look for this story on myfox8.com. Had a great time riding my bike.
I was gonna say, did
Matthew,
you got a pretty good workout
there? Yeah,
yeah, yeah,
that
I
was
got a
my workout,
you,
my exercise.
All over Winston-Salem.
Lots of great biking areas over there.
KC?
And in Greensboro and High Point,
oh,
too.
Yeah. We're talking